Everyone, so I am driving around town right now. Okay, I need to figure out what I want to eat and what will be semi-healthy or semi-fit into my shit. I don't like to use the term healthy because I personally don't see food as unhealthy or healthy anymore. I see it as like fitting your goals or not. So I feel like everyone has different goals, and I've tried to evolve my thinking away from healthy food and unhealthy food. What's that? Where's the healthy menu? Like the healthy options?
Okay, the menu says it's not really say healthy, or I cannot tell it's really healthy.
Okay. I know I just said not to use the word healthy, but this is a different exception because I'm trying to differentiate for their menu, which clearly they didn't do. Thank you.
Any salsa?
Yeah, can I get the hottest one? Yeah. Literally smallest water in my life, combined with the longest straw in my life. This is like so unnecessary. Okay. All right, you guys, I'm gonna eat this here, like in the parking lot, like a ratchet little. Before we get to the food, let me just show you guys really quickly what I got from Target. So I didn't have measuring spoons and cups. I know, super basic, but because I'm doing the whole like calorie counting thing, I really feel like this will help because yeah. Then I have Hims. So Hims is actually for men's hair loss, and they also now have Hers, so they are branching out for women as well. It's not just hair loss, although this is the hair loss kit, but I really like their packaging, and they're actually brand new to Target. Before that, they were just online only, so I was ordering online, and now I don't have to pay for shipping. But they have the shampoo here. The shampoo has saw palmetto, which is a herb, and apparently it's known to be good for hair loss or like increasing hair thickness. So they have minoxidil in here, which is essentially the Rogaine, and you know me, I have to get the nicely packaged of everything. I'm pretty sure it's probably the same price as Rogaine, but Rogaine is like such a vibe that I don't really feel like wanting to like associate myself with. There's also biotin, and then yeah, the shampoo. They also have conditioner and things like that, but I'm not sure how effective that is. So let's get to the food. I actually got a lot of food, and I feel like I shouldn't eat all of it, but let's see how it goes. And then I got the hot sauces. So the biggest thing I got was the grilled avocado burrito. So I feel like I should eat that, but I also want to try the turkey soft taco. If you guys like Del Taco, please let me know what you like about it and why, because I'm super, super new to Del Taco, and I want to know what good stuff they have. The hard tacos are really bomb. So honestly, to me, the cheese in these tacos is like virtually pointless. I just like pushed it out. Like seriously, shredded like raw cheese does nothing for me. So now time for the grilled chicken taco. These are the soft tacos, and basically have the same stuff inside with the white sauce. Let me show you guys. It looks pretty good, and I'm gonna put oh my god, this is so good. Same taco number two. the white sauce inside is probably a lot of calories, but we'll find out later. I'm not completely opposed to the counting calories method, even though I have been for the past like 10 years. Because I think the reason why I was so anti-counting calories is because people just obsess over it. And I've never seen a good example, a healthy example of someone counting calories. Granted, this is my day one, so we'll see how it goes. Taco Bell is definitely more of a vibe. It's definitely more of a cult classic. I don't even know if I'm using that fucking word right, but I mean, it's not bad. Del Taco is not bad. Also, I'm like really full, but I'm starting a fucking huge burrito. This is actually burning my mouth right now, but I did ask for the hottest one. Oh my god, I can't believe I ate all that. Actually, who am I kidding? I eat that much all the time. But no, like, I feel like it was one thing too many. And I could have definitely... Okay, I'm being f***ing disgusting at this point. But like, seriously, that was a lot. Basically, I'm gonna have to count those calories. And like I was saying, the reason why I like this is because I don't think I've reached 2,200 yet, but like depending on where I'm at, I'll adjust what I have for the rest of the day. So basically it'll allow me to essentially eat whatever I want, but I am trying to meet a protein goal as well. So my protein goal is about 200 grams of protein per day. So as long as I meet that and go under 2,200 calories, I should be fine on eating whatever I want. But that's the issue, is like, I don't know how many protein, like how much protein I got from this. But maybe that's an option for those of you who are either trying to build protein or lose weight or whatever you're trying to do. If you are going to end up doing calorie counting, don't go crazy with it. I think being super like religious about your calories or even just the intake of your foods is actually detrimental, because you're making yourself more stressed out, and in fact you're gonna end up binging or you're gonna end up losing track. I know I do for sure. When I'm like that or try to be like that, I end up saying like it, like I'm gonna beast on like literally everything in sight. So it's just not helpful, and I think being like more moderate is actually better for the long term. By the way, I want to hear about your guys' physical health goals in terms of like with food and like maybe your body, like that whole thing. Let me know in the comments below. Alrighty guys, that's it for this week's vlog. This was super random and spontaneous, but hope you enjoyed it anyway. See you guys in the next video. Bye.